The biggest summer festival in Siouxland is back after COVID-19 forced its cancellation just 1 year ago.
It did, and KCAU 9 News reporter Hannah Adamson joins us live now from the official 30th Saturday in the Park Festival at Grandview Park with more on the changes you can expect this year in our top story at 6.
Tim and Sophie, excitement is building here at Grandview Park. Hundreds of folks slowly making their way out. Of course, we got Gallivant right behind me. They just wrapped up out of Omaha on the main stage. And of course, this year's festival is bringing so many unique changes to it. It's the first time in Saturday in the Park's history the festival is split into two nights instead of one. And this year, you don't even need a ticket to get in. That's because general admission is free. Now, because some of Grandview Park is under construction, the area is completely fenced off, and that means you can carry alcoholic beverages you purchase at the festival throughout the park, with the exception of the Kid Zone. That area of the park is set to open tomorrow. Now, there was a lot of back and forth as to whether or not face masks should be required here at the park. Now, they are optional, but if you're taking that shuttle from the Tyson Event Center down to the festival, you have to be wearing your mask. Now, event organizers say they highly recommend taking that shuttle because anyone who knows anything about Saturday in the Park knows those parking spots fill up fast. So if you haven't gotten here yet or you plan on coming for day two, be sure you get a spot early. We'll have so much more from day one of today's festivities. And of course, all you need to know before you go on our website, that's SiouxlandProud.com. For now, reporting live at Grandview Park, Hannah Adamson, KCAU 9 News.
All right, Hannah, thanks for that update. The festival annually draws crowds of 20,000 fans and more, and organizers don't expect that that will be any different this year.
Absolutely not, especially with last year being canceled. KCAU 9's Mallory Smith spoke with a few people there who say they're thrilled to be back out celebrating after not getting that chance.
Saturday in the Park kicks off their 30th annual festival tonight, but this time on a Friday.
Haven't missed 1 year.
John Robinson has gone to every Saturday in the park since its opening. So last year, when the festival was canceled due to COVID, Robinson said he felt off. So he made the effort to get here extra early, claiming his spot at nearly 11 a.m.
And I really missed it. My family really missed it. So I love all the bands and the people, seeing different people.
And many Siouxlanders we spoke with would have to agree that the people are what make the event so special.
It's the group. It's everybody that gets together every year to do this. It's kind of like it's a family. It's not even kind of like a family. It's like seeing a family every year. And some of these people I haven't seen for 2 years now.
Awesome. I love being out and seeing faces. And I'm a nurse, so COVID was a huge battle for us. But it's great to see people out and happy. And it's nice to be out selling again.
Tasia Hart has been coming to the festival for a few years now. She says she's already missed enough and couldn't imagine another year without her favorite festival.
I think 2018 was maybe our first year, and I can't believe I live so close to Sioux Falls and didn't know about this. I look at all the history of the bands, like, gosh, I missed all this. So I'm like, I don't ever want to miss it again. Like, we want to be here.
Reporting from Grandview Park, Mallory Smith, KCAU 9 News.
And indie pop trio AJR will cap off night number one at Grandview Park. You may recognize their current hit. I know you probably know it.
I have.
Way Less Sad. Day two kicks off at 2 tomorrow, Saturday afternoon.
That's right. And if you'd like the full lineup of all of the bands, because there's a lot more than what we're mentioning here on air, you can check out our website right now at the address on your screen or the KCAU 9 mobile news app.